Hello friends, welcome back to a brand new episode, and in today's video we'll be doing a speed test comparison between the Galaxy J7 Max and the LG Q6. So let's quickly restart both the devices to see which device boots up faster. So on the left hand you have the specifications for the LG Q6, while on the right hand side you have the J7 Max. So the J7 Max has a 4 gigs of RAM, while the LG Q6 on the left hand has a 3 gigs of RAM. So clearly you can see from here that the J7 Max boots up faster in comparison to the LG Q6. So we'll be running two laps of the speed test. The first round will demonstrate which phone loads the application faster, and the second round will be executed just to see that which phone has a better memory management. So let's quickly see the multi-application menu. We have no running applications in the background, so both phones are nearly fresh. And let's go into this application called as CPU-Z to see the specifications. So on the left hand side, it is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 430 clocked at 1.40 GHz, while on the right hand you have the MediaTek MT6757 clocked at 2.39 GHz. Both have 8 cores. So swiping to the right, the device, the screen size is 5.70 inches with a screen density of 386, while here we have a 5.5 inch with a screen density of 442. The total RAM over here is around 3 gigs and over here it is 4 GB. So quickly seeing that the available RAM is 51% on the J7 Max while 52% on the LG Q6. Internal storage on the Q6 is 32 GB, while here also it is 32 GB. So let's quickly go to the home screen and let's see the system specifications. So you can see that the LG Q6 is running the latest version of Android, which is the 7.1.1, while the J7 Max is running Android 7.0. So let's quickly go back to the home screen and let's start with the lap 1. So the first application will be Temple Run 2. And as requested a lot, I'll be having a counter on the upward side to illustrate which phone is loading the application faster. So the J7 Max loads Temple Run 2 faster and the score now is 1-0. So let's quickly go back to the home screen and let's start with the second application, which is Subway Surfers. So on the left hand side, the LG Q6, due to its 18:9 resolution, is sometimes unable to run applications on full screen. But if you swipe up from the right downside, you have an option of the compatibility mode and you can enable that to run the games full screen. So once again, the J7 Max loads Subway Surfers faster, taking the score to a 2-0. So let's quickly go back to the home screen. So quickly starting up with the third game, which is Sonic Dash by Sega. And I also earlier did a speed test comparison between the J7 Pro and the LG Q6, in which the J7 Pro was the clear winner. It has a 3 gigs of RAM, so again you can see Sonic Dash loaded faster on J7 Max, taking the score to 3-0. So let's quickly go back to the home screen and start with the fourth application, which is the Riptide GP Renegade. So once again, faster on the J7 Max, taking the score to a 4-0. So quickly starting up with the fifth application, which is Smash It. F- 5.0 for the J7 Max. So next game is Riptide GP. So 6.0, again a win for J7 Max. So the 4 gigs of RAM is on an advantageous side, while the processor is clocked at a higher speed in comparison to the Snapdragon 430. So LG Q6 is a very good phone, look wise, feel wise and display wise, but if I had to rate a 7.0 now, Mario Run loads faster, then definitely the speakers on the LG Q6, the selfie camera are very weak, and I would have expected that a fingerprint scanner would have been a great inclusion. I don't know why LG missed the fingerprint scanner, as phones in the range of 9 to 10,000 also in India now are coming with a fingerprint scanner, but the Q6 missed it. So the first win for Q6 is on the camera. Now quickly going into the browser test, we'll be opening the website samsung.com. So let's quickly open Samsung. And we'll be loading articles to see which phone loads articles faster. So let's quickly click here. So loaded faster on the Q6. Let's quickly scroll down. So everything fully loaded now. And the scrolling speeds are okay on both the phones. So let's quickly click on learn more. Once again loaded faster on the Q6. So yes, a better browsing speed, as both are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. And Q6 is loading these websites faster. So let's click on buy now. So again, faster on the LG Q6. Let's quickly cancel this notification. So a second win for the Q6. Once again, settings load faster on the Q6, taking the score to a 7.3. So now quickly opening Flipkart application. So faster on the Q6, taking the score to a 7.0. So in lighter applications, the Q6 is gaining momentum and it is loading them faster. So now you can see that Amazon loads faster on the J7 Max. So the current score 8.4. Quickly loading the last application of the speed test, which is InShots. So once again, faster on the LG Q6. So let's quickly scroll up some articles to see whether some images are still loading. Yes, you can see over here that the J7 Max has some images not loaded fully in the background, while the Q6 has all of them loaded in background. So let's quickly go back to the home screen. So at the end of lap 1, we can see that the score is 8.5. So quickly we'll be starting up with lap 2. So just going into the multi-application menu and quickly we'll be running the first game, which is Temple Run. So you can see that the Temple Run is preloaded on the J7 Max, while the Q6 is loading it from the initial point. So let's now click on Subway Surfers. So once again, same thing with J7 Max. You have it preloaded in the background, taking the score to a 10.5. Quickly opening Sonic Dash. So very good memory management from J7 Max. The 4 gigs of RAM is playing an important and a vital role in the speed test, as it holds up all the application in the background, while on the left hand side the Q6, due to 3 gigs of RAM, struggles to open all applications and is not retaining even a single point. So you can see that the Riptide GP Renegade is loading on both the phones, but still the reloading also happens faster on the J7 Max, taking the score to a 12.5. So let's quickly scroll down and see what happens to Smash It. So retained the left position on J7 Max while loading once again on the Q6. So the score is 13-5, and we'll be going back to the multi-application menu, and quickly we'll be opening this application called as Riptide GP. So the same problem once again with Q6, but not with the J7 Max. So on a budget segment for around 17,000 rupees, I would definitely say that J7 Max is a very good phone. With 4 gigs of RAM, I would even prefer it over the J7 Pro, because that 1 gigs of extra RAM gives you some smooth operations and helps you in multitasking. Once again, you can see that even a game like Mario Run is preloaded on the J7 Max, taking the score to a 15.5. Let's open Play Store. So yes, opened at the same time on both the phones. Let's open camera. Loaded faster on the Q6. Let's open Chrome browser. So you can see over here that at the page where we left, J7 Max did not need to refresh the load, while the Q6 again loads the article, taking the score to a 16.5. Let's open Flipkart. So once again the same problem with Q6, the J7 holds the position and take the score to 17.5. Quickly going into the Amazon shopping application. So yes, preloaded on both the phones, keeping the score to 17.5. So let's quickly go into this application called as InShots. So preloaded on both the phones. So let's quickly go back to the home screen, and we'll be quickly going into the application once again on both the phones, the CPU-Z application, to see what amount of RAM is still available on both the phones. So let's quickly swipe a little left and go into the device. So you can see that the available RAM on the J7 Max is very less. It is only 441 MB, which is only 11% of the total memory, while on the left hand side on the Q6 you have an available RAM of 1243 MB, which is 42%. And the main reason of such high amount of RAM being available is that the Q6 lost all the games from the background memory, so it is nearly at the fresh position. And currently the winner of the speed test is the Galaxy J7 Max. Thank you so much guys for watching the video. I hope you like my work, and if you like, please hit the subscribe button. In the end, stay connected.